हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर शिवाजी वाळके. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ एबीएम 357, दैट इज स्ट्रैटेजिक बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट. आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑन बिजनेस पॉलिसी. सो इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी विल गो थ्रू मीनिंग ऑफ बिजनेस पॉलिसी, नेचर एंड स्कोप ऑफ बिजनेस पॉलिसी, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ बिजनेस पॉलिसीज, importance of business policy. Let's start one by one. First one, business policy. So basically, business policy is an combination of two words, that is business and policy. So try to understand meaning of these two terms separately. Okay, first one, business. What is business? Business means exchange of commodities and services for increasing utilities. What is utilities? It is an satisfaction purpose. Or in other way, I can say that business means exchange of goods and services for economic purpose. Okay, that one also okay. Then policy. Policy is an simply principle or tatva or rule of actions and guide to actions or channel of thinkings. Okay, it tells about rule of action, how any company has to act, okay, or guide of actions. This is called policies. When this policy and business comes together, we get business policy. Now we'll go through definition of business policy. Okay, first definitions. Business policy is a principle or group of related principles along with consequent rules related to that principles of actions that provide for successful achievement of objectives. Okay, business policy is an principles or group of principles along with some rules which provides or which actions provides the achievement of organizational objectives. It's called business policy. Okay, let's we'll go through another one definition. Then here another one. Business policy define scopes or spheres within which decision can be taken by subordinates in organizations. Subordinates or we can say employees. Okay, it is an scope or spheres, certain kind of limit, frameworks, okay, within this framework or within this box, okay, they have to take its all decision. It's called business policy. Okay, so another one, business policy also deals with acquisition of resources with which organizational goals can be achieved. Okay, it tells about acquisition of resources like land, labor, capital and management. Okay, it tells about acquisition of these resources for achieving the goals of organizations. Okay, then with the continuation of this part, business policy are guideline developed by an organization to govern its action. It is an guidelines or it is an work manuals that is developed by organization itself for maintaining its all actions. Okay, then business policies defines the limit within which decision must be taken. It is an certain kind of framework. Within this framework we have to decide, means which product we want to enter into market or which product we want to take out from the markets. Okay, likewise, then business policy is a study of roles and responsibility of top level management in the organizational hierarchies. At the top levels we have CEO, okay, then directors, then chairperson, okay, director body. Okay, so it tells about roles and responsibility of these persons. Okay. So whatever they are going to do duties, that is going to affect on organization success in long terms. Okay. Then natures and features of business policy. First one, business policy should be specific or definite. Okay, as per the requirement or as per the business aspect, it should be specific. Then it should be clear. There should be no unclarity or there should be no any unambiguous. Okay, so that everyone can understand it and grab it or work according to it. Then it should be reliable or uniform. It should be equal to all employees or all stakeholders who involved in organizations, or even for top manager also, even for low manager also. Okay, it should be equal to all. Then it should be appropriate according to the department or according to the business aspect. It should be the suitable for that department or suitable for that business. Then simple, it should be the simple to understand everyone, even your non-skilled labor or even your low skill labor should can understand your policies. Then it should be inclusive or comprehensive. It should cover all the aspects of business, aspects like marketing, HR, finance, then your operation, then supply chains. Okay, it should cover all these aspects. Okay, then it should be flexible. Okay, business policy should be flexible, so you can take decisions, okay, comfortably. Then it should be stable. Business policy should be should not like today is something else and tomorrow is something else. Okay, so this is about features or natures of business policies. Okay, in that what you have seen, it business policy should be specific, business policy should be clear, business policy should be reliable, business policy should be appropriate to that department, then it should be simple, then business policy should be comprehensive or inclusive, and flexible and stable. Okay, for your easy understand, you can make this or you can remember this short forms. Okay, scrap sheets. Okay, then let's start with scope of business policies. Okay, when it covers or while it covers many aspects of business, like as we discuss, marketing, HR, finance, operations, supply chain, then your relation management, internationalizations, all these aspects are covered with your business policies. Okay, and then it includes the functions and responsibilities of top level management or senior management that ultimately affect on your success of your business. Okay, it includes the functions and responsibilities of top level management. Then it deals with determinations of future course actions, means what you are going to do or what you are supposed to do in coming time or in futures. So it tells about future course of actions. Then it involves the choice of purposes and defining what need to be done in order to identify the organizations, means it gives choice purpose. Suppose within resource A or resource B, suppose your resource A is an by manually and resource B is an by machinery, so it gives choice indicator, either this one or either this ones. Okay, then it includes the resources by the help of which organization can achieve its goals. Resources like land, labor, capital and management. Okay, so it include the resources through which organization can could achieve its objectives or long term goals. Okay, then objectives of business policies. What are the different objectives of business policy? For easy understand, I have segregated this into two parts. That is, first one is in terms of knowledge, and second one is in terms of skill. So let's start with in terms of knowledge. It gives knowledge about the environment. What kind of environment? Business environment. Within that environment, you are going to conduct your business. Okay, that could be either external or internal. In external, you can say that social, cultural. Okay, then your politicals, then naturals. Okay, this kind of environment. Okay, then in internal, your 4 P's and your business aspect like marketing, operation, HR, finance. Okay, so it tells about or it gives knowledge about this business environment and how this business environment or how this external and internal factors affect on functioning of organizations. Okay, then it helps to determinations of missions, objectives and strategies of the firms. In coming lecture, we will discuss about what does it mean by missions. Okay, what does it mean by objectives and what does it mean by strategies in details. Okay, so for now we just try to understand what are the objectives of business policy. So it helps to determinations of missions, objective and strategies of firms. Then the learner is able to visualize how implementations can take place. Okay, so it gives frameworks. Business policy, what gives? It gives frameworks or scopes within which we have to take its all decision or all business decisions. So ultimately you can visualize how the implementations of any strategies or missions or objectives can take place. Okay, then the learner can understand the various aspects like strategies, policies, plans, programs. Okay, so this policies is different, plans is different, and programs is a different one. Okay, in coming lecture we'll discuss about it. Then in terms of skills, to develop analytical abilities, okay, and to understand situation. Analytical ability means what? Within resources A and B, okay, which one is goods, either machineries or either manpowers, which one is goods? That this ability is called analytical abilities, and understand the business situations. Okay, then to develop the skills of identifying factors relevant in decision makings. Okay, the skills means related to decisions makings, means problem solving abilities. It develop problem solving abilities within entrepreneurs or managers. Then increase the mental ability of learners and enable to learner to think about theory with business with practice. So it gives mental ability to learners, okay, and unable to think about theory with and practice of related to business strategies. Okay, sorry. Then leads to development of oral as well as written communication skills. Okay, so it ultimately develop leads to development in your communications skills. Okay, then last one, importance of business policy. Again, this one I have segregated into two parts. First one, for the purpose of understanding organizations. Okay, it provides the basic frameworks for the understanding strategic decisions while making a persons as it middle level of management. ओके. सो बेसिकली इट प्रोवाइड फ्रेमवर्क और लिमिट और स्कोप विद इन विच यू हैव टू टेक द डिसीजन. सपोज एनी मैनेजर्स मीन्स वॉट अप टू वॉट लेवल ही हैज टू टेक एनी डिसीजन. सपोज कंसिडर एनी मार्केटिंग मैनेजर. सो वॉट इज देयर वॉट इज हिज ड्यूटीज और हर ड्यूटीज ओके और वॉट इज हर रोल्स ओके. सो इट लाइकवाइज इट प्रोवाइड द ड्यूटीज और रोल्स इंफॉर्मेशंस टू द दैट पर्टिकुलर एम्प्लॉयज और मैनेजर्स. देन इट ब्रिंग्स टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस टू इट्स मैनेजर्स ओके. मीन्स वॉट इट ब्रिंग्स ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड मैनेजर एट वन प्लेटफॉर्म ओके. इट ब्रिंग्स दिस टू टूगेदर इन वन प्लेटफॉर्म. द बेनिफिट ऑफ द ईयर्स डिस्टिल द एक्सपीरियंस इन द स्ट्रैटेजिक डिसीजन मेकिंग फॉर बेनिफिटिंग बोथ ऑफ देम्स. इट ब्रिंग्स इन वन प्लेटफॉर्म्स फॉर टेकिंग डिसीजन्स. देन एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस पॉलिसीज मे लीड टू एन इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ जॉब परफॉर्मेंस ओके. सो इट हेल्प्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. सो अल्टीमेटली managers or employers jobs performance will get increases. Then last one, business policy understanding the business environment. So it gives ideas about business environment. What kind of business environment means what? The environment which directly or indirectly affect on business okay. Business environment like internal okay, either four fees और aspect like marketing, operations, HR, finance or external environment. In that social, cultural, political, naturals. Okay. So it helps to understand business environment. Then under that it create understanding the how policies are formulated or how the policies are formulated in organizations okay. Suppose this is an organization hierarchy. This is an top level management. This is middle and this one is lower. So in which the levels which policies or which decisions are taken. So it create enables to understand the how policies are formulated. Then this helps in understanding of complexities of environment that the senior management faces in policies formulations. So it gives the threats or various challenges of environments, business environment. Then by gaining an understanding of business environment, manager become more receptive to the ideas and suggestions of the senior management okay. So last time there was question on this same topics, define business policies or meaning of business policies and give its importance okay. So this is for today's lectures okay. So what we have discussed today is meaning of business policies, then business policies, or simply you can say business policies and simply protocols. Means in that protocols okay, in that protocols they have described the roles and responsibilities of top level management okay. Then we have discussed about natures or features of business policies okay. What are the features? Specific, it should be the specific, it should be the clear, it should be the uniform, then it should be the it should be the appropriate, simple, comprehensive, flexible and stable. This is about natures and features of business policy. Then we have discussed about objectives of business policy in that or sorry before that one we have discussed about scope of business policy like covers many aspects, then include roles and responsibilities of top levels management, then future scopes of actions, then
it will involve choice purpose or choice indicators, okay, within resources A or resources B. Then it helps to understand organization, or it helps to achieve the organization objectives. Then we have discussed about objectives of business policy. Under that, in terms of knowledge, then in terms of skills, okay, then we have discussed about importance of business policy, how business policies played important role in any business, okay. So this is about today's topic. I hope you understand. For further doubts, you can call me or WhatsApp me. Thank you. Have a good day.